always eager to fight. Kevin's new exercise resembled a dance more than a fighting technique. With all the noise he was making with his practicing, the family might have trouble sleeping tonight. Finding the herbalist was the most pressing matter. The healing herb needed to be taken to Mary as soon as possible.
Yeah.
In the darkest depths of the cave, further than a weary traveler dares to tread, lay the chamber of a Naiad and her god. The first step toward the mountain god. The poor herbalist had no valuables, but the goblin's greed had now surpassed gold and jewels. Shedding tears for the dead man would serve no one now. The herbs needed to be delivered to Mary. Vibrated with the pilgrims' chanted prayers, prayers offered to a deity that perhaps slumbered, unhearing, at the end of their journey. The hero did not know how many of them would survive the coming days. Grandma arrived in time to reveal the contents of the tablet. The secrets of Rhea are in the hearts of the stones, and for those whose weapons guard the creatures of the wild, there are new arts of war to be learned. She flaunted her wings, begging to be chased. Alarjo fled further. Further she fled. Relishing the chase, she accepted defeat. Thank you. Mark was out of the woods now. His fever gone, he was almost up and about. "Welcome back, brother," said Kevin. He had avoided conflict over the years, living in harmony with nature, but as Uncle Ben was fond of saying, a Bergson would forget how to walk before they forget how to fight.
Breaking, ever shaking, everlasting.